with intervals. Now, when we are dealing with intervals, you must know that we are dealing with the number of semitones within a distance. And then by distance, we mean from point A to point B. Now, our point, we take it as if you are from a certain note, for instance, from point note A or from point note B. So the distance that you are working or you are counting on now, it is an interval. And then when you are dealing with an interval, you've got three factors that you must think of. By factors, we mean the first point is the distance. Now, by distance, we mean, is the note from note number one to note number two a second or is it a third? So by that, basically, we mean the number of notes. Number of notes. And then by direction, we mean, are you going above or below? So basically, this is what we mean by direction. And then by time, we mean, is it an augmented? Is it a major? Is it a minor? Is it a diminished? And then, in order for you to understand the type, which is the augmented, you are guided, of course, by the number of semitones. Now, for instance, let's make an example now. You've got this note here. The name note is E. And then, perhaps we make an example of saying, find us a fourth, meaning a fourth above, in fact. And then meaning E is going to be our note number one. And then E, F is two, G is three, and then A is the fourth. Now, by direction, we would have tackled the question because we are above, which is we tackle the direction. And then, for instance, distance, we have also tackled the distance because from E to the A, you know the distance is a fourth. Now, in order for you now to be able to attend Okanye to count the number of semitones, you must first decide, are you in a major key or are you in a minor key? Because normally, we would use the scale of major as well as the scale of minor, right? And then, etc., etc. And then, for instance, if we are saying now, find us an augmented fourth, for instance. Now, you find us an aug fourth. Then, it means that an augmented fourth will be one semitone more than the perfect fourth. Remember, when we are dealing with the subdominant as well as the dominant, these two are perfect because of the number of semitones. Now, the number of semitones between the fourth and the fifth, it's perfect. And then from the perfect fifth, you will have your augmented. And then from the perfect fifth, you will have your diminished. So now we must first establish the perfect fourth. It has how many semitones? One, two, three, four. There we go. Meaning two, four, five. So for a perfect fourth now, you have you've got five semitones. And then for an augmented fourth, it means that you will now need six semitones. And then this is where our piano now comes in. Right? This is our piano, for instance, in this case. This is our piano. Okay. Now, this is our piano. And then we are saying from a natural E, which is here is the natural A to the natural A. You will have now to count the number of semitones, meaning half steps, which is one, two, three, four, five. Then it simply means that from a natural E to a natural A, you've got a perfect fifth. And then this simply means that now, since you are getting five semitones and you need six, you must add another semitone. That leaves us now to the A sharp. Meaning an augmented fourth is from a natural E to a sharp A. Do not forget that you always put your exit and down before.